It's Iowa State and Iowa today in the Iowa Corn Cyhawk Series as these two teams battle it out here toward the end of their seasons. There you see the overall and conference records for the two opponents. And they're going to introduce the starting lineups here momentarily. You can still see some rain coming down. It's not heavy rain, but it's just, Mitch, it's been that steady diet of raindrops throughout the day and very cold temperatures, very windy. It's obviously far from ideal conditions to play today.
Yeah, you talk about tough playing conditions. It's this kind of weather that these guys want to go out and play each other, but it's the kind of weather that you take cautiously when you're in the field, especially when you're an infielder, you're going to see the ground balls, you're going to see them hop up on you, especially later on in the game. Out in the outfield, you're going to see players possibly slip. You're going to see them pick up the ball and maybe overthrow it because of the wet hand. As you see, 45 degrees out here. It doesn't feel like 45 outside, though.
And
for
that
sure.
Strong wind at 16 miles an hour out of the east to southeast. So blowing in here today, it could be hard to get one out of the ballpark today. They're introducing the starting lineups. Talk about Mitch, ground balls. The infield, you know, when they put the tarps down, it's just over the pitcher circle.
Yep.
And home plate. So the rest of the field, you know, absorb that rain. So it's kind of a muddy track as far as ground balls. How will that affect ground balls?
You know what? Actually, in the beginning of the game, it's going to be a good thing for these players for the first few innings. Maybe possibly after the first inning, it's going to get rough. But as an infielder, you like the ground moist because then the ball doesn't hop as much. But as the game goes on, you're going to get those cleat marks, you're going to get the foot marks, and those are going to stay there. So versus when it's a dry day, you can soften those out, whereas now it's going to hop up on you. So that could be a potential problem here later in the game.
You see the Hawkeyes. They're coached by Marla Looper in her fourth season. Iowa State is coached by Stacy Gemeinhardt-Sessler in her ninth season with the Cyclones. And the Cyclone lineup being introduced as we speak. You can see the enthusiasm from the Cyclone players there, Allie Kappert and others. And Iowa State will be wearing their Cardinal jerseys today with the gold numbers. And as we mentioned, about a five-minute delay in the start of this one due to the conditions today, but we will be getting it going here any minute. It's going to be a pitching matchup today of Katie Johnson for the Cyclones, who just came back yesterday from illness. She had missed a couple of weeks, but she is back and will get the start here today. And then it'll be Kayla Massey, the ace for the Hawkeyes, as they send their best to the mound here in this single game, not a doubleheader, just one game today between Iowa State and Iowa. And you just saw Rachel Hartman a moment ago, her two-run homer. The catcher for Iowa State was the one that forced extra innings yesterday in game one against South Dakota. Cyclones came back to win that game on a base hit by Lexi Slater in the eighth, and then fell in game two to South Dakota. So opportunity to get back to the 500 mark on the season yesterday, but couldn't get it done as they got a split with the Coyotes.
Talk about how cold it was for these players earlier and how some of them might not want to exactly be out here, would rather other conditions, but then again, you look at this as the Iowa Corn Cyhawks series, and it is Iowa versus Iowa State, so you know the rivalry, so you're going to want to go out there and play this game, no doubt.
And there you see the Cyclones wrapping up their introduction. Both teams on the baselines now. And we are going to listen in as our national anthem is played.
For the playing of our national anthem.
Thank you. And you can see the wind whipping around out there as those flags are blowing in today. And Iowa State and Iowa ready to get it going here in just a couple of minutes here at Cyclone Sports Complex. The umpires take the field, and so will the Cyclone defense. And we will set the lineups for you as best we can as they came in kind of late. Here is the hitting lineup. And you know what? I'll tell you what. Let's just take it off the screen, and I'll give you what it actually is, because it's a little different than what we were guessing at there. It's going to be Brianna Luna to bat first for Iowa, and she will play left field. Claire Fritsch is the second baseman. She will hit in the number two spot, and then Megan Blank, the top hitter for Iowa, will hit third. She'll play shortstop. It'll be Holly Hoffman to catch and hit cleanup. And then Whitney Repley will be the designated player, and she will hit in the fifth spot. The pitcher, Kayla Massey, will hit sixth. Aaron Erickson is in the seven hole, and then it'll be Michelle Zeller to hit eighth, and Caitlin Malarkey will hit ninth and play first base for Iowa. And the Cyclones defensively look like this. It'll be Sarah Harluck playing left field today. She was out in right field yesterday, so she swaps positions with Allie Kappert. Kappert played right, Mitch, a couple days ago. Harluck just coming back from injury. They left her in her more comfortable position of right field last yesterday's games. Kappert did a pretty nice job in left, but you know she's new to the outfield game as it is, and she's allowed a little versatility. So she'll be in right field today, Harluck in left, Brittany Gomez in her familiar spot in center. Maddie Reese has done a nice job playing a lot more lately at third base. It's Lexi Slater at short. Sarah Davison at second. Jordan Spendlove at first. The catcher's Rachel Hartman. And on the mound is Katie Johnson. And we are ready to go.
John, important for Katie Johnson to come out here with a quick start. Especially you talked about yesterday. Didn't get out to the best performance that she could have had, but has a chance to rebound here. And I think the biggest thing for her is I was 5-13 on the road. So if she can get out early and get her team behind her and put some runs up on the board, I was 0-20 when they score two runs or fewer versus three runs. They're 13-5. So if Johnson can limit that, success for the Cyclones.
Johnson, a freshman out of Sioux Falls, South Dakota. We mentioned she's pitched the bulk of the innings for Iowa State on the season. And we are underway as the opening pitch is a ball to Brianna Luna, the left fielder for the Hawkeyes. Luna hitting .312 on the season, one home run, eight RBI. She stands in from the right side. Johnson winds and delivers the 1-0. And that misses inside, 2-0 the count. Luna has three steals on the season. Iowa doesn't run a lot, not compared to Iowa State, which at the top of their lineup runs considerable amount. There's the pitch, and this one driven foul by Luna out of play. So it's a 2-1 count. Glad you could join us today, Iowa State and Iowa, in the Iowa Corn Cyhawk Series. Hawkeyes wearing their black jerseys with the gold numbers. Here you see Hartman giving the signal to Johnson, and here's the 2-1. Fouled off again by Luna. Again, she was out in front.
You might see a few of these pitchers, both pitchers early, you might see a few of their pitches kind of left over the middle or left over the inner half versus where they want them because it's cold out, because it's windy and wet, so could be a factor early.
Luna, one of six Iowa players from the state of California. Iowa State's roster is also sprinkled with Californians. Here is the 2-2 pitch, and that missed the outside corner, so the count runs full on Luna. Iowa State also with six players from the state of California, so that state well represented here in the Iowa Corn Cyhawk Series. The pitch on the way, and there's strike three. Johnson gets her swinging. Luna the first out of the game.
Nice pitch there by Johnson to get her first out to help herself out there, kind of.
Katie Johnson ran the count full and then came back and struck out Brianna Luna, and that'll bring up Claire Fritsch, the second baseman for Iowa, number seven. Left-hand hitter digs in. So Johnson, with her 129th strikeout of the season, by far the team leader in that category. She's well out there in terms of innings pitched as well, but a little bit more of a strikeout pitcher than the others that Iowa State can put on the rubber. 0-1 the count here, one away in the top of the first. Johnson to Fritsch, fouled off.
I think some of these California players you were talking about earlier are saying, what the heck, why did I come here in this kind of weather?
Well, you know what? There's much better days than this.
There is.
In the spring here in Iowa, no question. But today is not the best. But they're going to get this one in, or at least try to. And here's the pitch. Fritch fouls it back again. So the count 0-2 now. So Johnson working out in front this time after striking out the leadoff hitter, Brianna Luna.
Fritch is a 255 hitter, and she has 18 strikeouts on the year. So let's see if Johnson can get her 19th.
Here's the 0-2 delivery. And Fritch was unwilling to chase that high fastball. 1-2 the count. This is the final game in a 9-game homestand for Iowa State, which was a welcome sight after a long, long time on the road. Here is the 1-2 delivery, and that's just fought off by the hitter Fritch. Megan Blank is on deck. See, the rain is still steadily coming down. It's not a heavy rain, but it's there. That's bothersome, and it's kind of been that way all day in Ames. Here is the delivery by Johnson on 1-2, and a strikeout again for Katie Johnson. She struck out the first two hitters of the game, both swinging.
Nice pitch there by Johnson. Good off-speed pitch, kept it low too for other reach of Fritch. So nice job. Good start by Katie Johnson.
Megan Blank will stand in for Iowa. Blank, their leading hitter, a 3.36 average. She's also the team leader in RBIs with 18 from her leadoff spot, or rather batting third, I should say. Here she is, the left-hand hitter, and she takes that pitch, and it's ball one. Blank, a junior from Culver City, California. The 1-0 from Johnson. And that pitch missing also 2-0 now.
Rain's starting to come down a little harder here at the Cyclone Sports Complex.
It is. It's definitely raining harder than it was earlier. 2-0 the count. Two away here in the top of the first. And Johnson delivers. And that pitch misses up high. So 3-0 now on Blank. And we see the catcher Rachel Hartman come out to have a word with Johnson. Probably telling her it's not raining.
It's difficult to grip the ball in this kind of weather,
too.
I mean,
Johnson will try the 3-0 delivery here to Blank. And that misses up high, ball four. So a runner aboard for Iowa on the walk by Megan Blank. And that'll bring on Holly Hoffman, their catcher. Both catchers hitting in the cleanup role in this game today. Hoffman, a sophomore out of Osceola, Indiana, bats with a runner aboard here. Blank 3-for-3 on stolen bases on the season. Johnson delivers. And Hoffman takes up high, ball one. Just underway here. Top of the first, Iowa State and Iowa. And there is Hoffman popping one up to the right side. Jordan Spendlove fighting the raindrops and makes the catch in foul territory. So a good first inning for Katie Johnson. And we'll go to the bottom of the first with no score. We are back here at Cyclone Sports Complex. And we go to the bottom half of the first. Let's take a look at the batting order for Iowa State in this Iowa Corn Cyhawks Series showdown. Brittany Gomez will lead off. She's just under 400 on the season. Sarah Harluck playing left field and hitting second. It's Lexi Slater at shortstop hitting third. You can see Rachel Hartman has her average up to 373 on the season. She's the freshman catcher for Iowa State. It's Allie Kappert in right field. Jordan Spendlove, the first baseman, Sarah Davison, Sarah Rice, and Maddie Reese round out the Cyclone starting lineup. And defensively for Iowa, they will have out in left field Claire Fritch. Their center fielder is Whitney Repley. Brianna Luna in left. It's Aaron Erickson in center and Alyssa Navarro in right. It's Michelle Zeller, Megan Blank, Claire Fritch, and Caitlin Malarkey around the infield third to first. Holly Hoffman is the catcher, and the pitcher is Kayla Massey. And Mitch, tell us a little bit about her.
Well, Massey's got a 2.46 ERA, and this is her 22nd start of the year, and she's actually pitched 145 innings. So she's a strong pitcher for Iowa, but I think if Iowa State can come out early, swing the bat, they got the potential.
There you see the defensive alignment for the Hawks. And it'll be Brittany Gomez to lead it off for Iowa State. Massey delivers, and that one all the way to the backstop as it slips away from the catcher, Hoffman.
Seeing Gomez lay down a bunch of bunts this year, so I think, especially in this kind of weather, she can get something down. There's a possibility that Zeller over there at third can botch the throw with this wet kind of dirt.
Yeah, you talk about probably getting a ball to deaden on a bunt. It might just stick today. There's another pitch up high, so Gomez ahead in the count 2-0. Gomez had her batting average slip just under the 400 mark for the first time in a long time yesterday, but she is at 397 among the Big 12 leaders in hitting. She takes a strike here. Gomez with 29 runs scored on the season, team high 22 stolen bases. 2-1 the count here to Brittany Gomez. And the delivery, chopped to the left side, a beautiful piece of hitting, and there's a base hit for Gomez. Just exactly what she was trying to do.
Couldn't put it in a better spot. Zeller too far in and Blank too far away to make that throw over to first.
That's what Brittany Gomez has in mind pretty much every time she steps to the plate. We couldn't place it any better out there. So now Harluck will come to bat for Iowa State with good speed on board at first in the person of Gomez. Probably not ideal running conditions, but at the same time, not ideal throwing conditions for the catcher, Hoffman. And the delivery to Harluck swung out and missed. And there's strike one. Bottom of the first, no score here at Cyclone Sports Complex. Sarah Harluck hitting 341 on the season. Iowa State among the national leaders in batting average. A look by Hoffman, and scampering back to first was Gomez. The count 1-1.
Yeah, Hoffman behind the plate certainly knows over there that Gomez is a threat to run, so making sure she looks over a couple times.
Cyclones, as we mentioned in yesterday's broadcast, 16th in the nation out of 350 teams in batting average. And Harluck chops that one foul. It's 1-2. So they have gotten it done with the bats all year, hitting well over 320 as a team. And it's been inconsistent pitching and defense that have cost them.
Yeah, we've talked about this every single time we're out here. It's not the hitting that kills the Cyclones. It's definitely the defense and pitching that you were just talking about.
Their average 327 as a team. That pitch low and throw to first. Gomez gets back. So the count now even at 2-2. But with that 327 average, Stacey Gemeinhardt-Sessler would like to see more runs scored as a team. They haven't exactly been timely with their hitting. There's been times where they've left many runners on base. Here, Harluck to the left side, places it out there nicely. She'll beat that one out. So it's first and second for Iowa State on two infield singles by that speed at the top of the Cyclone lineup. Harluck and Gomez each on board.
Yeah, hey, Harluck hit that ball right there, as we're going to look at here. Kind of chopped it in the dirt, and like you talked about earlier, it could stick a little bit, and Zeller no play.
And no chance for Zeller to throw it across the diamond. So now Lexi Slater comes up with two runners aboard. Great speed on the base paths for Iowa State here in the bottom of the first. Massey delivers, and Slater takes, and that's ball one. Massey, a 2.46 ERA on the season. She's pitched well. Not a big strikeout pitcher, just 80 strikeouts in her 145 and a third inning. So she'll get about one every two innings. That's not her most effective way to get hitters out.
Definitely one of those pitch-to-contact hitters and trust the defense behind you.
Massey delivers here on the 1-0 count, and that one bounces in front of the plate. The runners are going, and they're in there easily. Gomez diving into third with her 23rd stolen base of the season. Harluck picks up her 11th. So both of them moving up. And now a real opportunity here for Lexi Slater here in the bottom of the first.
Another thing when you're on base today is to read that dirt ball read. So when the ball's down in the dirt, you're going to get more of an opportunity to get over to the next base, especially in this wet weather.
Here's the pitch, and that gets away. Gomez will scamper home with the first run of the game. And Harluck on to third. So that speed on the base pass really causing havoc for the Hawkeyes. And Gomez scores the first run of the game. Harluck on to third base now. And the umpires are coming together, and I don't know if they're going to delay this thing. We might see it. That pitch got away, and Gomez scoring the first run of the game. By the direction the umpires are walking,
I mean, you got...
You take that as a bad sign, don't you?
You got the Iowa players doing some laps here, trying to stay loose, and you got the umpires going off the field, so... I don't know.
Mitch and I are going to step out for a few moments, and we'll try to come back and play this thing, hopefully. They are wiping off home plate, and I think we're going to get some softball in here. Here come the Hawkeyes onto the field. So they give the pitcher, Caleb Massey, some warm-up throws as she allowed those two infield hits and then the opening run on a wild pitch.
See if Massey can have a little better control now that it's not raining out and a little less muddy. So see if she can get a little more control and see if she can get out of here.
We approach 6 o'clock, the delay about an hour and a half. And there is Kayla Massey, the senior from Foothill Ranch, California. Iowa State started with freshman Katie Johnson in the circle, and Katie had a very effective first inning for Iowa State.
You know, for the umpires out here, I mean, I know both coaches and both teams want to play, obviously, but the umpires are just kind of trying to keep these teams safe in a condition like this. I mean, you got a wet field, you got a wet mound, especially for the pitcher, so the last thing they want is for these athletes to get injured, so props to them for looking out.
And there's Lexi Slater. She will stand in with the 3-0 count, by the way, and a runner on board at third in Sarah Harlock.
Important here for the Cyclones to see if it can't come back out. And Slater's got a 3-0 count at the plate, so she can draw a walk possibly and then bring up another Cyclone, see if it can get some more runs on the board.
Well, as we say on the Cyclone tailgate tour, Mitch, let's play the feud. We will give it a try. Lexi Slater will stand in to face Massey with Iowa State ahead 1-0 here in the bottom of the first. Final meeting on the mound, and we're ready to play ball just about right at 6 o'clock here. 1-0 Iowa State in front, and Lexi Slater will stand in with a 3-0 count.
Wind blowing back in now.
Not quite as hard.
Yep.
That pitch a strike, so 3-1 the count. And not quite as many fans have made it back into the ballpark. There was actually a pretty good crowd here at the start, but not everybody decided to wait it out. And there's a pitch in there for another strike. Massey coming out of this rain delay with a couple strikes back-to-back. 3-2 the count now.
It's got to be so difficult as a player, especially like in Lexi Slater's position, to come back out here and try to get a base hit.
There's the pitch, and that one misses for ball four, so Slater draws a walk. Cyclones have first and third with nobody out, and Rachel Hartman, the cleanup hitter, coming up. Hartman is really putting together a great freshman season. 373 average, 4 homers, 25 RBIs, a 532 slugging percentage. She moved up to the cleanup role yesterday and is in that role again today, and she fouls one off.
Yeah, if Hartman can keep her swing hot and deliver an RBI here, that'd be huge for the Cyclones in the bottom of the first.
1-0 Iowa State in front, runners at the corners, nobody out. Massey delivers, and Hartman takes on the inside half for a strike. It's 0-2 now. Here's the 0-2 pitch. And Hartman takes up and away, so 1-2. Slater staying at first for now.
Notice these Iowa infielders backing up the pitch, which they do often, but especially important in this kind of condition when you have a wet field to establish that.
Massey delivers, and a swing and a miss by Hartman. The runner down to second. Slater's in there. Now the throw home, and also safe is Sarah Harlock, and the Cyclones lead it 2-0 on the double steal.
Nice job there by Slater to develop that double steal and take off early and get over to second, and then nice job by Harlech to get into home.
Another look. The play at second was close, but Slater just in there, and then Harlech able to score easily. So now Allie Kappert will bat. And that pitch is in there for a strike. So the strikeout for Hartman. But another run scores, and the Cyclones are up 2-0. Allie Kappert out of Ankeny, facing Massey and taking a pitch down low for a ball, 1-1.
Kappert's another dangerous hitter for the Cyclones, hitting .372 so far in the year with 48 hits. So she's got potential to drive in more runs, as she has 35 RBIs. As you see there, she's got potential.
Team leader in home runs and RBIs, checks her swing there on a high pitch for a ball. They'll appeal it, but they say she didn't go around. So it's a 2-1 count to Allie Kappert. One away here in the very long bottom of the first. And Kappert back up the middle. Massey looks the runner back for a moment, then throws on to first, but moving up anyway is Slater. Could have gotten her in a rundown, I think, Mitch.
Yeah, I think mistake kind of there by Massey. Fortunate for the Cyclones, didn't hold up Kappert, or didn't hold up Hartman over there, over at second long enough to look her back, and she moved over to third. Nice job by Slater.
I mean, the look was just kind of a token look. And now standing in is Jordan Spendlove and taking ball one. So the runner at third now is Lexi Slater, two away. And Spendlove also has been swinging a hot bat. Back up the middle she goes, and that will be an infield hit for Spendlove. Brings home Slater, and it's 3-0 in favor of Iowa State.
Nice hit by Spendlove. I mean, if you can keep it on the ground in this kind of condition, it's going to hop a little more, as you can see there. And so nice job there by Jordan Spendlove to get on first. She picks up another RBI.
Cyclones up 3-0 here in the first. And now Sarah Davison with a swing and miss. Spendlove, the infield single and RBI, her 22nd RBI of the season. The 0-1 delivery, and Davison takes, and that one just misses the outside corner, 1-1.
Sarah Davison, a .292 hitter on the year with 3 home runs and 21 RBIs.
And Davison holds off, but that pitch hits the outside corner. It's 1-2. Davison has had a good homestand. She hit in the second spot in the lineup when Harlech was out with a back injury and did very well in that spot. Here she just fights a pitch off to stay alive. 1-2 the count.
Davison's one of those hitters that when she does get down on the count, she's going to fight it off and continue to fight it off. So she's a good hitter and a good addition for Iowa State.
Sarah Davison on the season has struck out just 5 times in 130 at-bats, one of the best ratios in the country. So by far the toughest hitter to strike out in this Cyclone lineup. A 1-2 delivery, and that one taken down low, 2-2. Spendlove the runner at first, 3 runs in here in the first. Iowa State in front, 3-0. Good look at Jordan Spendlove, or Sarah Davison, I should say. She swings and fouls this one back. Out of play. 2-2 the count.
Again, nice job by Sarah Davison to fight off that outside pitch.
Sarah, native of St. Louis, senior. 2-2 delivery on the way for Massey, and that one misses away. Full count now to Davison. So Spendlove, the runner at first, will get us head start here. She'll be off with the pitch. 3-2 count, 2 away. And Davison to the left side. They'll go across the diamond. Low throw, but they dug it out. Good play over there by Caitlin Malarkey at first. So the Cyclones get 3 in the first inning. We go to the second. Iowa State up 3-0.
Shouldn't your network work even when you don't want to? Whether you're out of pocket up here, decompressing way out here, or defrosting just the other side of nowhere, shouldn't the choice to be out of touch be up to you and not your spotty wireless provider? At U.S. Cellular, we started our network where the others left off, bringing 4G LTE to nearly 90% of our customers. We've got local and national coverage covered. U.S. Cellular, hello better.
Cyclone Sports Complex, where Iowa State leads Iowa 3-0 as we go to the second inning. Katie Johnson on for her second inning of work. And Mitch, pretty close to 2 hours between her first inning of work and her second inning of work. That's the long rain delay and then the bottom of the inning concluding. So it's been a while since she's been out there.
It's been a long while since she's been out there. And it takes a certain mental kind of player to come back out here in this kind of situation, pitch strong and get the Cyclones back in the dugout and see if we can't put up some more runs.
There you see the numbers for Johnson in the first inning. She pitched very well, struck out the first two hitters she faced. She'll face Whitney Repley, Kayla Massey, and Aaron Erickson for Iowa here in the top of the second.
Johnson did a nice job last time out. Obviously, in the 2 hours that she was out last, getting two Ks out to start, so let's see if she can't do that again right away.
Whitney Repley stands in and takes a pitch up high for ball one.
Repley's a 264 hitter on the season with 23 hits and 8 RBIs. Hits him on the top of the Iowa lineup.
And the delivery on the inside corner. 1-1 the count. Repley from San Antonio. Iowa State's Jordan Spendlove also from San Antonio. That pitch is off the plate. It's a 2-1 count now. Katie Johnson facing Whitney Repley here in the top of the second. Cyclones leading at 3-0. And the 2-1 delivery on the way. Chopped foul at the plate. 2-2.
Nice job there by Repley to continue to fight and fall that one off her foot. Probably doesn't feel too good on a cold day like today, but managed to fall that one off.
Iowa swept Missouri a week ago today in a doubleheader. Missouri ranked number 13 in the country at the time of that Iowa sweep in Iowa City. And that pitch just misses ball three. Full count now to Repley.
You talk about how Iowa swept Missouri. I mean, they are 6-9 versus the top 25, so it's not like this Iowa team can't put up a good performance against good teams.
3-0 Iowa State here in the top of the second. And the delivery to Repley. And that hit her bat, fouled back. So we'll stay at 3-2. You see Lexi Slater playing back at short. Leadoff hitter here in the second inning is Repley. And she takes it to right field, but foul. And again, we'll reset things for a 3-2 pitch.
Again, nice job by Repley to put her bat out there and kind of just follow it off. We're sending out the last two pitches now.
Katie Johnson is yet to allow a hit. 3-2 delivery coming here to Repley one more time. And that one hit the bat?
Must have.
Okay.
Couldn't tell
if it hit the bat or forearm. And she's indicating right there, you saw a great shot of it, that it hit the very bottom of the bat.
And that's a bummer as a hitter.
Yeah. The umpire can usually tell by the sound. A bone sounds a lot different than a bat. So it will be 3-2 again. And Johnson winds up one more time. To the left side, Slater charges, fires across the diamond way high, airmailed it, and moving up to second will be Repley. So you can see how difficult it is to get a good grip on that ball. As you know, it was a play, Mitch, where there really was no reason to rush for Slater.
I mean, you see Slater on this ground ball kind of come up and charge it, get it on the short hop, but she has some trouble throwing it. I mean, that could be because of a wet ball or just something she didn't like when throwing it, but you're going to have those kind of conditions in this weather.
Tough error for the shortstop Slater on this wet field as she tried to throw that across the diamond, and now the pitcher for Iowa, Kayla Massey, stands in there trying to help her own cause and takes a big cut and misses strike one.
Massey's hitting .234 in the season, has 22 hits and 13 RBIs, so she has the potential to hit in a few runners. We'll see if she can do so here.
She's the team leader with 5 home runs, and she took a big cut right there. 0-1 the count. And that pitch up high, 1-1. So Iowa threatening here in the second. Whitney Repley, the runner at second after reaching on the air. And Massey trying to bring her home with nobody out. Johnson delivers, and that pitch misses outside. 2-1.
Nice job there by Massey to hold off on the outside corner, and good pitch by Johnson, who's tried to get ahead, but couldn't do so.
2-1 delivery from Johnson. Massey to the left side, but foul out of the reach of Maddie Reese. So it'll be a 2-2 count now.
It's kind of interesting to me that the outfield, Gomez, Cappert, and Harluck aren't playing in a little bit, especially on a cold, windy day with the wind blowing in a little bit. The ball's not going to travel as far as a warm day, so kind of interesting that they're not playing in a little bit.
They have pretty good respect for Massey's power. She leads this Iowa team in homers. She takes a pretty big cut, but here she takes ball three. So 3-2 the count. And nobody out here in the top half of the second. Iowa trails Iowa State 3-0. The payoff pitch to the left field and deep. And wind or no wind, that is long gone. A 2-run homer for Massey, her 6th of the season. And it's a 3-2 game.
Nice swing there by Massey. I mean, got it on the inside a little bit and put that one out in left field. Like you said, wind or no wind, that one was gone.
Kayla Massey with a home run to left. There's another look at it. Pitch on the inner half, Mitch, and she just hammered it. Didn't take a huge swing. That was kind of the old Glenn Allen Hill chopping wood swing right there. But got plenty of the barrel of the bat on that thing and drove it out of here.
Talk about power, especially on the wind. Not wind blowing in, not too hard, but still blowing in. I mean, she's got some power to put that out there. There's no doubt.
Aaron Erickson will stand in. It's a 3-2 game now here in the second. So the first hit of the game for Iowa is a 2-run homer. And now to the right side, that's Davison. On to Spendlove for the out.
Nice shot by Davison to stay down on that ball and throw it over to first for Spendlove to create the first out. Nice pitch by Johnson.
Brings up Michelle Zeller. So one away now here in the top half of the second, a 3-2 Iowa State lead. But Iowa chipping away with that 2-run homer by Kayla Massey. Set up by the air.
So there's a .227 hitter on the season so far. Has 25 hits, but 110 at-bats.
The 0-1. And she takes on the inner half for strike, 0-2. Katie Johnson, the right-hander out of Sioux Falls. Came into this game with a 17-15 record. That pitch up high. 1-2.
A lot of promise for this Cyclone team, though, when you have a freshman in Katie Johnson throwing the amount of innings she has so far this season, and then obviously was out for a few games, but very promising for the Cyclone program.
128 Ks in her 188 innings of work. And this one to center field. Brittany Gomez got a pretty good jump, but it does fall in front of her for a base hit. So a single for Zeller, second hit of the inning. And now it'll be Caitlin Malarkey to bat for Iowa with a runner aboard and one away.
Yeah, you see Gomez try to come up on this ball and potentially make a diving play. But on a line drive like that, especially when it's wet out, that's a difficult play to make versus a high fly ball kind of dive.
Runner at first is Zeller, and Malarkey stands in. And they throw down to second. is in time to get her, Rachel Hartman. They were going to try the bunt, but Malarkey didn't get anything she could handle, and then Hartman threw down to second for the out.
Hartman throws down to second from her knees and gets her in time. See, it doesn't stand up there, and Slater comes over and makes the tag. Nice job by Hartman.
So Zeller caught stealing, and two away now here in the second. Great throw by Rachel Hartman, the freshman catcher for Iowa State. It's a good look at Rachel. She's been swinging the bat very well also. Fouled back here in a 2-1 count now on Caitlin Malarkey.
Malarkey hasn't had a lot of at-bats for Iowa. She only has 44 on the season, but is still hitting .227, so good nine-hitter for the Iowa Hawkeyes.
The 2-1 delivery from Johnson to Malarkey. Left side and out of the reach of Reese, foul. It's 2-2. Iowa State got three runs in the bottom of the first, mostly due to good base running. Three infield singles in that first inning for Iowa State. Iowa's answered in different fashion with the long ball, but there's another strikeout for Katie Johnson, her third of the game. And Iowa able to score two, but we go to the bottom half of the second. Iowa State leads it 3-2. Some Brave fans braving the elements here at Cyclone Sports Complex. Not a perfect day for softball, but they want to see the Iowa Corn Cyhawk series. And right now it's a good ball game, 3-2. Iowa State leads it as we go to the bottom of the second. Got an hour and 30 minute rain delay here, but they are going again. It'll be Sarah Rice to lead it off for Iowa State. There's strike one.
Nice job by the Hawkeyes to come out in the top half of the second, especially after a long rain delay like that, and put up two runs. That was huge for them.
Yeah, they needed it, and the pitcher was the one that provided it as Massey delivered a two-run homer. Now she's got a 1-1 count here on Sarah Rice. There's the season numbers on Rice. The 1-1, and that pitch is in there for a strike, 1-2.
Massey helping herself out there, putting up two runs for the Hawkeyes.
Maddie Reese is on deck, and then it'll be the top of the order for Iowa State. 1-2 count to the right side and foul, 2-2. We mentioned it early in the game that Kayla Massey is not a big strikeout pitcher. She pitches to contact, tries to use her defense. She does have a 2.46 ERA. She's allowed 138 hits in her 145 innings. Just 55 walks. She struck out 80. That pitch up high for a ball. 2-2.
So far, nice job by Massey coming out here and getting herself established again early, whereas we saw in the bottom half of the first inning before the rain delay, she had kind of had some trouble controlling her pitches, whereas now she's having a little better.
There's a swing and a miss, strike three. So Rice is down on strikes, and that'll bring Maddie Reese to the plate. Reese has really picked up her batting average of late. Then 176 might be misleading as I say that, but she was down below 100 coming into this homestand, and she's really swung the bat well here in the last few games. Four hits yesterday, a doubleheader.
Yeah, when you can get that many hits on a homestand and bring your average up above 100, that's mental confidence for yourself, and especially for Maddie Reese sitting at the bottom lineup. That's huge for her.
She's been really doing a nice job of hitting all over the field here in the last couple games. That one cued down the line, and will it roll fair? No, it stays foul.
Kayla Malarkey, not sure why she didn't pick that ball up in foul territory to begin with. I mean,
yeah, maybe she was hoping Reese wouldn't run, but yeah, once Maddie started, you gotta pick it up, I would think. 0-2 the count here, though, to Maddie Reese. And she takes, and that one just misses, 1-2.
Nice pitch there by Massey to keep it low, especially in this kind of weather.
A few raindrops still here at Cyclone Sports Complex. And an hour and a half delay. Reese just barely fouled that off. taking a kind of an interesting approach here, Mitch, with two strikes. She's taking that running start from the right side. We'll get a new softball in there. Glad you could join us here today on Cyclones.tv. Broadcast carried across the state as well on Mediacom. And again, Reese just trying to chop it down that first baseline. That one just foul.
Nice job there by Reese just to put the bat out there and fall it off to the right side.
So 1-2 remains the count on Maddie Reese.
As we talked about earlier, Kayla Messi is, she's one of those pitchers that's going to pitch contact, and so far she's done that. Especially, you want to go after the nine hitter if you're Massey here.
She does, but Reese chops it into Shola center. It's going to drift out there to the center fielder and be caught by Aaron Erickson. So Reese able to make contact, but she's retired. Two up, two down for Iowa State here in the second.
Good two-strike swing there by Maddie Reese to put something out there, but couldn't do the job.
Brings up the top of the order, Brittany Gomez. She singled and scored in the first inning. Used her great speed to work all the way around the bases, and now she tried to put down a bunt, but it's fouled. Strike one.
Top of this lineup for the Cyclones is so dangerous, as we saw in that first inning.
The 0-1 to Gomez. And that pitch misses 1-1. Gomez with that base hit has that batting average up very close to 400 once again. Came into the day at 397. Iowa State's leader in that category, a swing and a miss. It's 1-2.
See how far Zeller and Malarkey come in. We'll see if Gomez can't do the same thing she did in her first at bat and maybe chop it over to the left side.
The 1-2 delivery. Gomez fouls it off her foot. Stays at 1-2. And we'll reset things. Two away here in the second inning. Cyclones made some noise in the first with three runs, but so far they've gone quietly here in the second. 3-2, Iowa State in front. Massey to Gomez. To the left side again. It'll be another infield hit for Brittany Gomez.
Same kind of thing she did last time. Sticks the bat out there, and Zeller, unfortunately, in the wrong position. That one was lasered right at her and couldn't come up with the play.
And you got to believe anything to that left side. Gomez has a great shot to beat out. You got to play it so cleanly. And so Gomez on with her second hit of the day. And here comes Sarah Harluck. And that pitch is a strike to get her started. Gomez, Iowa State's top base stealer, the career record holder at Iowa State with 53 in her career, which as just a sophomore is a very impressive amount. Now Harluck to the left side, and she'll beat that one out. No, they called her out at first. I thought Harluck was in there, but they did rule she was retired just in time on the throw. So the Cyclones put together a minor threat, but do not score in the bottom of the second. We will go to the third, 3-2, Iowa State leading.
Say bye to the dish.
Why?
You're getting Mediacom.
Why?
Because it's boundary free.
Why?
Because you can watch TV any way you want. Because DVR is included. Because you can watch TV everywhere. Because it's reliable in all weather. Because there are thousands of free shows on demand. Because we don't require a contract.
Why?
Why should we? It's easy to see why better TV is boundary free TV from Mediacom.
MidAmerican Energy is putting the power to achieve greater energy efficiency in our hands with free home energy audits, rebates on energy efficient products and appliances for our homes. Businesses win too through financial incentives and rebates on energy efficient equipment. Green saving power is in our hands with MidAmerican Energy.
Welcome back to the Cyclone Sports Complex. I'm Mitch Gerber, joined by John Walters. As the Iowa Hawkeyes don't allow a run in the bottom of the second inning to the Cyclones. And John, so far, I mean, we've come back from the rain delay. Hawkeyes have come out early, put up two runs. Cyclones couldn't put up one in the bottom of the second, but so far, so good for the Cyclones.
Yeah, they have a 3-2 advantage, and Katie Johnson goes to work. She's allowed just a couple of hits. The one earned run after the runner reached on an error on a throw by Lexi Slater, and then the home run, of course, by Massey. But it's a good ball game here, Mitch. 3-2 going to the third.
So Brianna Luna will come to the plate as she fouls the first one off to the right side for strike one. Cyclones with four hits versus the Hawkeyes two so far. As Katie Johnson comes to the mound. Luna struck out in her first at-bat. Johnson delivers. Strike on the inside corner, 0-2 count.
Good job by Johnson working ahead in the count. Going right after this top of the lineup for Iowa.
So the 0-2 pitch from Johnson is a changeup high. 1-2. Luna is a 3-12 hitter before this game started.
I think we'll see a few times where the ball kind of slips out of the hands of people throwing it today. We already saw it with Lexi Slater's throw to first earlier.
And here's Johnson's 1-2 pitch. Swung on, fly ball to Gomez in center as she trots over, camps under, and puts it away for the outs.
So great job getting the leadoff hitter there for Katie Johnson. Always so important to do. She got Luna on strikes in the first and comes back, gets her on the pop-up here in the third.
So that'll bring up Claire Fritsch for the Hawkeyes. Fritsch struck out in her first at-bat on a strikeout. Playing second base for the Hawkeyes as Johnson winds and delivers. Swung on, followed back to the backstop.
Yeah, she got those first two hitters of the game swinging. Johnson did, including Fritsch.
Fritsch is a freshman from Round Rock, Texas.
Big 12 country.
Yeah. And the 0-1 pitch from Johnson is a changeup for a strike.
So again, Johnson, just as she did with the last hitter, Mitch, getting out in front of the count, throwing strikes. Great to see.
One out here in the top half of the third. As Katie Johnson looks in and sets and delivers. Swung on, followed away to the left side. Now you talk about how important it is for Johnson to get up on these hitters, especially after they blank the Cyclones in the bottom half of the second.
You know, that rest might have done her some good. She missed a couple of weeks, but an opportunity to kind of get the batteries recharged.
The 0-2 pitch, swung on, foul back.
Fritsch just trying to stay alive here in the at-bat. Fought off a couple of pitches.
Umpire walks over the Cyclone dugout to get some fresh, dry softballs. Majorly important on a day like today. So one out here in the top half of the third inning. As Claire Fritsch is the batter for the Hawkeyes. Katie Johnson sets and delivers, and that one will get away from Rachel Hartman.
Trying to get her to chase something down in the dirt. Fritsch wasn't playing along.
Fritsch has 19 strikeouts, excuse me, on the season. It's the 1-2 pitches delivered from Johnson. Swung on, fall back to the left side.
Fritsch, their team leader in steals with 6 on the season, so decent speed. And she's just trying to get something she can slap into play and hopefully beat something out at first base for the Hawks.
So the one out, 1-2 pitch. And to Fritsch, she swings it over to the right side. Davison throws over to first for the second out of the inning.
Right at Sarah Davison, so not too much of a challenge there. She throws on to Spendlove and gets the out. And it's 2 up, 2 down. Again, good job by Katie Johnson going after the top of this lineup for Iowa. Luna and Fritsch retired in order, both in the first inning and now again in the third.
Yeah, especially nice job by Sarah Davison to stay down on that ball over there because it could get a little hoppy over there as the game continues. So that'll bring up Megan Blank. She walked in her first at-bat. Johnson delivers the first pitch down for a ball.
Blank, the best hitter in this Iowa lineup, 336 on the season. team-high 18 RBIs as well, and she leads the team in walks with 13, so she's been productive.
Johnson throws in the last softball for a new dry one. Two outs here in the top of the third, and the 1-0 pitch up high for a ball.
Blank with that good eye. Mentioned the team leader in walks, her on base percentage over 400 at 413.
Blank, a great hitter for the Hawkeyes. As Johnson looks over for the 3-0 pitch. Delivered low for a ball. Excuse me, now 3-0.
Yep. So pretty good plate discipline from Blank. And now Johnson's got a groove one. She'll probably be taken all the way.
So here's the 3-0 pitch. That one is delivered for a strike.
And wind is still blowing mostly in from left center, where we look at the flags, and a little bit toward left, but it's kind of swirling around more than anything, but mostly blowing in. The home run by Massey went right into the teeth of that wind.
The 3-1 pitch is delivered low as Megan Blank draws a walk.
Her second walk of the day.
Great discipline by Megan Blank. Yeah, not a lot of rain anymore. Not raining at all. Field's kind of dried out. Turned out to be all right.
So far?
So far.
We'll see if that second cell comes in or not, but right now it's improved dramatically.
So Holly Hoffman will come to the plate for the Hawkeyes. She flew out to first base in her first at-bat, and she takes strike one from Johnson. Talked about Blank over there as the leading base stealer for the Hawkeyes with 6 so far in 11 attempts. This Hawkeye team, not a huge threat to steal bases. As the 0-1 pitch is delivered high for a ball.
Johnson having to work a little bit here in the third. She's allowed 2 hits on the day. Clinging to a 3-2 lead.
And here's the 1-1 pitch to Hoffman is inside for a ball, 2-1.
Johnson was working ahead of hitters, but she got behind 3-0. Against Blank, and now is dropped behind here, and so Brittany Weilmiller, the Cyclone pitching coach, will come out to visit with Katie Johnson.
So if you're the coach, what are you saying to Katie Johnson in this kind of situation? Obviously the mound isn't prestigious on a sunny day like it would be, or the ball might be a little slippery. I mean, we can see there with the shot, there's a lot of mud coming out of the mound.
Yeah, look at those shoes.
Holy cow.
Yeah. And we're only in the third inning.
So the umpire coming over to take a look. Calling for someone of the grounds crew members.
I think they're going to bring out some fresh sand.
So the Hawkeyes have one runner aboard and Megan Blank in the top half of the third inning as Johnson tries to work out of a 2-out, 2-1 pitch. So we will send it to break and be back with more. You're watching Cyclones.tv.
Shouldn't your network work, even when you don't want to? Whether you're out of pocket up here, decompressing way out here, or defrosting just the other side of nowhere, shouldn't the choice to be out of touch be up to you and not your spotty wireless provider? At U.S. Cellular, we started our network where the others left off, bringing 4G LTE to nearly 90% of our customers. We've got local and national coverage covered. U.S. Cellular, hello better.
back to a wet and soggy day here at the Cyclone Sports Complex as the Iowa State Cyclones lead the Iowa Hawkeyes 3-2 with four hits for the Cyclones and two for the Hawkeyes. One error for the Cyclones so far, as you can see the Iowa State grounds crew working on the mound as Katie Johnson had a little trouble with the mud on her cleats, gets a little pick out there, picking off the dirt you can see there.
Now they're doing everything they can to give these players an opportunity to compete. And that was a pretty muddy spot there a moment ago, and I'm sure it still is despite the new bag of dirt. I'm going to bring one more bag out, it looks like. So,
I mean, you can only dry it so much after the rain delay, but then as the game continues going, that dirt's just going to get pounded and pounded in there more. So that's why we see the grounds crew out right now.
It doesn't look like they'll go to the second bag. They'll just stick with the one they got. The second bag looks like it's going to home plate. So another short delay here is the weather itself not as much of a factor right now. It's cleared up here, in fact, here at Cyclone Sports Complex, but just the field conditions, thanks to that earlier rain, that steady diet of rain. We had an hour and a half rain delay. Iowa State led it 1-0 in the bottom of the first when that rain delay started. When they finally got it going again, the Cyclones added two more runs in that first inning for a 3-0 lead. Iowa answered on a two-run homer by Kayla Massey in the second to cut it to 3-2, and that's where we stand right now here in the top of the third inning. Cyclones, as they've had many opportunities to do so far today, are visiting out on the mound.
So, John, if you're Katie Johnson right now, you come in. In the top half of the third, you get two outs right away, and then you kind of struggle a little bit. I mean, could be a little mental factor with the mound kind of being all muddy, but what do you do if you're Katie Johnson?
I think she's probably okay. I mean, this should help. They got the pick out to let her work at the mud in her cleats, so she probably feels better about that, and the surface is certainly going to be better once they're done working on it here. So, you know, she's pitching well, Mitch. She's struck out three. She's only allowed, as we mentioned, just two hits on the day. So all in all, she's had a good performance and is working with the lead here. So no reason for her confidence to be shaken at all.
Holly Hoffman is still the hitter for the Hawkeyes. And after Hoffman will be Repley and Messi. So the last thing you want to do is give up a couple hits and then face Kayla Messi again as she hit a home run last time.
Very true. And kind of the heart of the lineup up here for the Hawks. And Johnson will get a few warm-up pitches in. We'll be out at the Drake Relays, Tom Korshel and myself, throughout the weekend. So watch for our reports on Cyclones.tv. As Iowa State will send out its very competitive track team to try to win some championships. They'll start out tomorrow by trying to defend their title in the 4x1600 women's. Tomorrow evening in the Distance Carnival at the Relays. We look forward to bringing you some coverage on our digital network, Cyclones.tv, throughout the weekend.
Hopefully it's a little nicer for you out there.
You know, I think it will be. And hard to talk Tom into going to track, especially the Drake Relays, but was able to twist his arm and get it done.
And the 2-1 pitch to Hoffman is delivered for a ball. 3-1 count. Two outs here in the top of the third. Blank the base runner for the Hawkeyes.
Harlech playing deep in left field.
She is. Johnson delivers a 3-1 pitch for a strike on the inside corner.
Real good pitch coming back there. And now that runner at first will be off. That's Megan Blank. And she'll take off when this pitch is delivered with 3-2 count and two away.
Talk about Blank as the leading base stealer for the Hawkeyes. So not a stolen base here, but we'll see if she can run a little bit as the 3-2 pitch is delivered, swung on, followed by Hoffman.
Right off her instep. Not a comfortable feeling, especially on a cold day.
Can't be.
She's trying to fight off a little pain right now. You can see that she's she's not too comfortable, and she's going to hobble over to her coach, and I'm not sure if she's going to be able to continue. Right off that instep, which on any day is no fun, but when it's cold like it is today and you foul it,
makes it even worse.
Oh, man. Trying to walk it off.
Probably stings for a little bit longer than normal. So trainer comes over for the Hawkeyes.
Go spray it.
Great crowd out here for the 2-hour rain delay. I mean, not as big as when we started, but pretty good sized crowd for a cold evening.
Hoffman's okay now.
So the count's still 3-2 here with two outs in the top of the third. Megan blanked the base runner at first. She'll be going as soon as the pitch is delivered. So the 3-2 pitch to Hoffman. Johnson sets and delivers, swung on to deep left field. Gomez tracks over, makes a nice catch on the track, and Gomez puts the Hawkeyes away in the top of the third. Cyclones do up next in the bottom of the third. We'll see what they can do. You're watching Cyclones.tv.
Shouldn't your network work, even when you don't want to? Whether you're out of pocket up here, decompressing way out here, or defrosting just the other side of nowhere, shouldn't the choice to be out of touch be up to you and not your spotty wireless provider? At U.S. Cellular, we started our network where the others left off, bringing 4G LTE to nearly 90% of our customers. We've got local and national coverage covered. U.S. Cellular, hello better.
And welcome back to the Cyclone Sports Complex as we see Brittany Gomez making a nice running catch on the track for the Cyclones. She put away the Hawkeyes in the top of the third with one runner on for the Cyclones.
Brittany Gomez, she gets a good jump on the ball out there in center field. Really covers a lot of ground. It's always great to have a good defensive center fielder. And, you know, we talk a lot, Mitch, about what she brings to the table at the plate, so to speak. But she does a lot defensively for Iowa State, too.
And we talk about how she never really switches her position out center field, but that is because she can track so much ground that it doesn't really affect her one way or the other. As Lexi Slater will come to the plate for the Cyclones, it'll be Slater, Hartman, and Cappert. The first pitch is delivered for a strike.
Lexi Slater walked, stole a base, and scored earlier in the game.
So the 1-0 pitch from Messi is delivered low for a ball. Cyclones have four hits on three runs. Hawkeyes have two runs on two hits.
366 the season average for Slater.
Slater hits it over to the right side, and Fritsch throws over to first for the first out of the inning. Kind of a little defensive swing there by Slater, trying to put something together. Swung it over to the right side.
Yep, not much she could do with that pitch on the outside half. Just got it off the end of the bat. So we'll see what Rachel Hartman can do.
So the first pitch to Hartman is delivered low for a ball.
Hartman struck out in her first at bat, but yesterday, game one of the doubleheader, she hit a shot high off the wall in right center for an RBI double, then hit the home run to tie it.
And swung on foul back to the backstop for the first strike.
What a great find for the Iowa State softball program. Rachel Hartman's been .373 average, four homers, 25 RBIs in the season.
Hartman, a freshman from California. Count is 1-1 with one out as Kayla Messi delivers the changeup up for a ball.
Another California native was Tori Toroscano, who played such a huge role for Iowa State in recent years, now as a volunteer assistant in the Iowa State program.
So Hartman takes the pitch outside for a ball, 3-1.
Nice to keep Tori around. She contributed so much as a hitter, as a pitcher. Just did a little bit of everything for Stacy Gemeinhardt-Sessler.
So Messi delivers the pitch low for a ball as Rachel Hartman reaches first base on a walk.
Sets up a nice opportunity here for Allie Cappert.
Cappert does have 35 RBIs on the year. Hartman over at first. So Kapert takes the first pitch low for a ball. So Messi kind of struggling to find her zone here.
Not sure if we'll see Shayla Starkenberg in this game, but that was Kapert's teammate on Ankeny's state championship team. And each in their second year in the program, Kapert never redshirted, so she is a true sophomore. And Starkenberg, a backup pitcher for Iowa, is a redshirt freshman.
So Kapert took the pitch for a strike. The 1-1 pitch outside for a ball, 2-1. I wonder what kind of relationship Kapert and the Hawkeyes have. So, I mean, if you're friends in high school, you go to the opposite sides, what kind of, I mean, is there a little rival there?
I think so, probably. A little bragging rights on the line today, for sure. 2-2. That's what, another of the many things that's great about this series. Just the friendly rivalry between not only the fans, but many of the athletes involved in the series.
Unlike any other in the country, as Kapert waits for the 2-2 pitch, swung on, and strike three to Allie Kapert.
Kapert doesn't strike out much, so a real good pitch that time from Massey. And be up to Jordan Spendlove to try to keep this inning going.
Jordan Spendlove in her first at-bat, reached first base on a hit. She waits for the first pitch, and it is up for a ball.
Yeah, she went right back up the middle in her first at-bat, got an infield single that drove in a run. Made it a 3-0 game. Right now, 3-2.
The 1-0 pitch for Messi is outside for a ball.
Spendlove has also been swinging the bat very well, up to 341 on the season. Iowa State, as we mentioned, has a lot of hitters in this lineup that can do some damage.
The 2-0 pitch is low for a ball. 3-0 now. Hartman, the runner at first. Spendlove, the hitter for the Cyclones. As the 3-0 pitch is delivered, swung on, foul to the left side, but foul.
3-0, and she had the green light. Tried to take one down the left field line, just missed. That shows you a little bit of how hot Spendlove has been at the plate, that Stacey Meinhardt-Sessler would give her the green light on the 3-0.
Spendlove from San Antonio gets the pitch outside for a ball.
Just missed.
So Spendlove walks for the Cyclones as Hartman moves to second, and Sarah Davison will come to the plate for the Cyclones.
Second walk of the inning and the third of the game for Iowa State. So Massey normally has pretty good control, but she's walked a few Cyclone hitters, trying to be careful here today.
And the first pitch to Davison, swung on to right field and can't come up with that one. Sarah Davison is going to go to second. Hartman will score, and here comes Spendlove, and she will score. Sarah Davison reaches third base with two outs for the Cyclones.
A two-run triple for Davison, well placed down that right field line, and two big runs for the Cyclones to increase that lead to 5-2.
Yeah, Navarro couldn't quite catch this one as she drifts over to the right, but couldn't come up with it, and Sarah Davison with a nice piece of hitting.
And once she dove for it, you knew that Davison was going to head all the way to third.
So we'll see if Sarah Rice can do something as she follows one to the right side.
Tried the same approach there.
Just missed it.
You don't see a ton of triples in this ballpark. It is a hitter-friendly park, but tough to get all the way to third, but we've seen Davison do it here.
As Sarah Rice takes the pitch down low for a ball. 1-1 now.
Let's see if Rice can get her home. That runner standing at third and two away. Rice struck out in her first at bat.
And the 1-1 pitch is delivered outside for a ball. It's a huge hit for Sarah Rice, especially in a 3-2 ball game like this. So Messi delivers the pitch, swung on and missed by Rice. It was a big hack.
Yep, she takes a good swing. She does take a healthy swing up there, and when she hits it, she usually drives it pretty well.
So the 2-2 pitch swung on and fouled to the right side by Rice.
You know, Mitch, one thing that's great about this Cyclone lineup, you can't just breathe easy when you get through the top half. The bottom half is every bit as productive. Sarah Davison, Spendlove, Rice, Reese, there's some good hitters in that bottom half of the Cyclone lineup.
Two outs. The 2-2 pitch to Rice is swung on and missed. So the Cyclones get two in the bottom of the third from Sarah Davison's triple as the Cyclones put up 2 runs and have 5 runs on 5 hits. We'll see what the Hawkeyes can do in the top of the fourth. You're watching Cyclones.tv.
Hey, check it out.
DSL. It's so cheap.
Like it? Now people will switch back.
Well, MediaCom is still up to 10 times faster.
Yeah.
And pretty much necessary for homes with lots of devices.
Well, yeah.
And the recent FCC report said that MediaCom delivered on its 15 meg speeds, and DSL didn't. So, really?
DSL is overpriced.
Yeah. The fact is, with faster proven speeds, more people switch to MediaCom for the real deal.
We'll never know if somehow, in some way, we can affect the outcome of a game. But when the clock's winding down and everything's on the line, we all believe.
Welcome back to the Cyclone Sports Complex. As the Cyclones score 2 runs in the bottom of the third inning from the Sarah Davison triple. Cyclones have 5 runs on 5 hits and 1 error. Iowa Hawkeyes have 2 runs on 2 hits and no errors. And up next for the Hawkeyes is Repley, Messi, and Erickson. John, pretty impressive hit from Sarah Davison there to deliver for the Cyclones.
Yeah, big triple to drive into and give Katie Johnson a little breathing room here. And we'll see how Katie responds here in the top half of the fourth inning. She's got a 3-run cushion now.
Repley last time up, reached on an error from Lexi Slater's throw.
Iowa not a great hitting team, Mitch. Mm. They're hitting just .243 as a team on the season. We mentioned the Cyclones up at .327. So, you know, 3-run lead can be significant against the Hawks.
So Katie Johnson will deliver and swung on foul deep to the left side.
Way out in front of that, puts it up on the netting on top of the pitching cages down there, and or the batting cages, I should say, and way out in front.
Repley had a few of those in her first at bat too, where she followed it deep to the left side. See if she can adjust as she waits for the 0-1 pitch from Johnson. Down low for a ball.
She eventually reached on an error by Sarah, or rather by Lexi Slater, the shortstop, a throwing error, allowed her to move on to second, and then it was followed up by the 2-run homer by Kayla Massey to account for Iowa's 2 runs.
The 1-1 pitch is swung on and fouled back to the backstop. 1-2 now. Repley digs into the box, waits for the 1-2 pitch from Johnson. Johnson winds and delivers. Swung on, followed deep down the left side again.
Yeah, she's getting out in front of that ball. That one about hit Paris Emmels, who's down there getting loose in the bullpen. And just about took her out. There's Emmels. It's like, geez, I'm just standing here innocently.
And here's the 1-2 pitch to Repley. Outside for a ball. 2-2. Hawkeyes have 2 runs on 2 hits. Their 2 runs came in the top half of the second on a messy 2-run home run. So Johnson delivers the 2-2, swung on foul down the left side.
Guess you're not going to get to the gymnastics meet and their banquet, I should say.
Guess not.
On schedule.
That's all right.
Well, it's nice of them to invite you in. I know they appreciated all the coverage that you and Kyle Steingraber and the rest of our crew had all year long on Olympic Sports Spotlight.
The 2-2 pitch is delivered low for a ball. 3-2 count to Whitney Repley. As the wind continues to blow in here at the Cyclone Sports Complex, Johnson delivers a 3-2, swung on down the foul down the left side again. So Repley, one of those hitters that you're not going to get out on that inside pitch, that's for sure.
Yeah, she keeps fighting it off. Getting to see a lot of pitches. Helps her teammates out, too, when they can get a good look at everything that Katie Johnson has to offer. And Katie has thrown just about every pitch in the book here to try to get her, and she'll try it again here on a 3-2.
Johnson's 3-2 pitch on the way. Swing on fly ball over to Gomez in right field. And she's not going to catch up with that one. That one is gone. Whitney Repley delivers a home run as that one kind of got up in the jet stream and went over the wall.
Yeah, that wind looks like it's blowing in, Mitch. And if that's the case, that was really well struck as Repley drives one to right center. Finally got a pitch she could drive down. The right-hand hitter just kind of golfed it to right center and just over the fence for a home run.
Yeah, it looked like Gomez was going to run over, track that one, and catch it. And that one kind of just kept going. So
yeah, I think the wind, you know, I think even though the wind looks like it's blowing in, the ball is carrying pretty well. Yeah. We thought that on Massey's home run as well, that for the kind of the chopping swing that she took at that ball, it really carried out of here. So she'll stand in, and second home run of the day now for the Hawks.
So Kayla Massey will stand in, wait for the pitch from Johnson, and that one is inside for a strike. A nice job there by Repley, though, to continue to battle in that at-bat, followed several pitches off to the left side, and then delivered one that a pitch she liked and put it over the fence.
Her third home run of the season.
So Messi waits in his high fly ball, and that one is going to reach the back of the stands.
Yeah, that one got up there.
0-2 count now to Messi. She delivered a home run her last time up. Katie Johnson looks in. The 0-2 pitch swung on back to Johnson, thrown over to first to Spendlove for the first out of the inning.
Well, Massey going much more quietly than she did the first time. 1-3 on the put out. So nice recovery by Katie Johnson after allowing the home run to come back and get that next hitter.
Yeah, nice outside pitch there by Johnson. Swung right back to her and throws out a first for the first out of the inning. That'll bring Aaron Erickson to the plate. Johnson delivers the first pitch high for a ball. Erickson grounded out to second her first time up. So the Hawkeyes continuing not to shy away. It's the 1-0 pitch from Johnson is delivered. Appeal down to first base. Yes, she did go. So 1-1 count now.
Erickson, yet another of the Californians in this game. She's from Oakland. 12 players in all in this ballgame from the state of California. 6 on the Iowa roster, 6 on the Iowa State roster.
As the 1-1 pitch is delivered for a ball, 2-1 just missed. It's a lot of Californians.
It is. They must have just tremendous high school softball out there. You know, South Dakota came in here yesterday. They had several Californians on their roster.
The 2-1 pitch from Johnson is delivered inside for a ball. You know, it's so fortunate for those schools out west and down south to be able to play softball and baseball year-round and have the ability to play in warm weather and on nice fields versus inside a gym. So definitely an advantage. The 3-1 pitch is delivered from Johnson. Swung on over to Maddie Reese. Reese picks it up, fires over to Spendlove for the second out of the inning.
Good play by Reese. She knew she had to kind of hurry because that was a slow roller. And she didn't waste any time. Take another look here at the quick reactions by Reese. In softball in particular, you have got to make that throw very quickly. And Spendlove able to grab it in plenty of time.
That'll bring Michelle Zeller to the plate for the Hawkeyes. It's the first pitch from Johnson is delivered and in there for a strike.
So Johnson allows that leadoff home run, but she settled down nicely after that to get the next two hitters.
Zeller reached in her first at-bat on a base hit, but was caught stealing on a nice throw from Hartman. The pitch is delivered for a strike, 0-2.
Good pitch right there to get ahead 0-2. Johnson settling in nicely here.
With an 0-2 count here with two outs in the top of the fourth inning. Zeller waits for the pitch, follows it back. Hawkeyes so far have put up one run in this inning. It's a 5-3 ball game. As Katie Johnson winds and delivers up high for a ball. 1-2. After Zeller is Malarkey, the 9-hitter for the Hawkeyes. And the 1-2 pitch outside for a ball, 2-2.
Try to get her to chase something just off the plate, but good plate discipline there for Michelle Zeller.
Zeller made a nice play last inning. In the field as she swings and fouls it to the left side. Kind of getting a little darker out here as we reach sunset.
Same thing. It's just amazing timing on that thought. And no lights here at Cyclone Sports Complex, so they'll move along at the fastest pace they can.
The 2-2 pitch is on there for strike three.
And that'll help.
Katie Johnson delivers a strikeout for the Cyclones, and that will do it for the Hawkeyes in the top half of the fourth inning. Up next for the Cyclones will be Maddie Reese in the bottom half of the fourth inning. You're watching Cyclones.tv.
Say bye to the dish.
Why?
You're getting Mediacom.
Why?
Because it's boundary free.
Why?
Because you can watch TV any way you want. Because DVR is included. Because you can watch TV everywhere. Because it's reliable in all weather. Because there are thousands of free shows on demand. Because we don't require a contract.
Why?
Why should we? It's easy to see why better TV is boundary-free TV from Mediacom.
MidAmerican Energy is putting the power to achieve greater energy efficiency in our hands with free home energy audits, rebates on energy-efficient products and appliances for our homes. Businesses win, too, through financial incentives and rebates on energy-efficient equipment. Green-saving power is in our hands with MidAmerican Energy.
Back here at the Cyclone Sports Complex on a cold and wet night here at the Cyclone Sports Complex. Iowa State leads this one 5-3. Cyclones have 5 hits and 1 error to the Hawkeyes, 3 hits and no errors. Hawkeyes put up one run in the top of the fourth on a Repley home run as Maddie Reese comes to the plate for the Cyclones and takes down low for a ball.
Reese flew out to center field in her first at bat. Kind of chopped away at one and it carried out to center.
So the 1-0 pitch to Reese. Swung on over to the right side but foul. Stacy Gemeinhardt says they're trying to give Reese a little instruction over there at third.
Reese started 55 games last year.
And Reese delivers a hit down the right side. And she'll deliver a hit for the Cyclones with no outs here in the bottom half of the fourth. Nice piece of hitting there by Maddie Reese.
Always good to get that leadoff hitter on. And Maddie Reese continues her red-hot homestand here. She's really played her way into more playing time. Just went with that pitch. Took it into shallow right field. Dropped it in there perfectly for a base hit. Good job.
Fritch and Navarro both kind of having trouble getting to that ball. Reese put in the perfect spot. So that'll bring up the top of the order for the Cyclones, Brittany Gomez. First pitch is a ball. Gomez always a threat to bunt as Malarkey and Zeller come in on the corners. Pitch is down low for a ball, 2-0 to Gomez.
We've seen Iowa State be aggressive on the base paths in this game. Reese is 1-for-1 in stolen bases this season, so not a huge threat to run, but we'll see.
The 2-0 is perfectly put by Gomez. Couldn't have been hit better. Almost a swinging little bunt put perfectly between the pitcher and second base.
Yeah, second baseman over to cover at first. First baseman charging, so just an absolutely perfect bunt by Gomez.
I mean, you can't put in a better spot than that. Nice job by Brittany Gomez.
That's one where if there wasn't a runner in front of her, Gomez almost might have reached second on it because it was just rolling away from everybody.
And Sarah Harlock puts one over to Zeller. Zeller throws it over to short and over to third for the first out of the inning.
Well, they got the lead runner, so good play there as Reese is retired. It's 5-6 on that put out, and then now you got the good speed on the base pass, though, with Gomez at second, Harluck at first, and only one away, and Lexi Slater at the plate. So good opportunity right here for Iowa State.
Lexi Slater will take the first pitch, swung on and missed. 0-1 to Slater. Harluck kind of tried to do the same thing as Gomez there, trying to put one down third, like Gomez would normally do. So the 0-1 pitch, swung on, foul to the right side. So the camera guy almost got hit.
Nobody's safe today. You could be in the bullpen, you could be shooting pictures, you be in the dugout, you better be on your toes.
The 0-2 pitch to Slater is delivered outside for a ball. Gomez and Harluck are the base runners for the Cyclones. Kayla Messi, the pitcher for the Hawkeyes, delivers outside for a ball. 2-2.
Well, if Lexi Slater can put one in a gap, Cyclones will score two here, but with the kind of speed they have on the base paths.
Slater takes and fouls it back to the backstop.
It's keeping that count right at 2-2. Slater having just a terrific season. Hitting 366, 7 homers, 30 RBIs.
2-2 pitch by Slater, swung on for strike three. Two outs for the Hawkeyes here in the bottom of the fourth inning.
Big strikeout right there for Kayla Massey. She tries to get out of this jam. Sort of leave it up to Rachel Hartman.
Hartman struck out in her first at bat and walked in her second. She takes the first pitch outside for a ball. Hartman, the 1-0 pitch, swung on over to right field. Navarro picks it up, and Gomez is going to score as Rachel Hartman delivers for the Cyclones.
Well, she continues to just have a terrific homestand. The RBI single to right. She walked earlier in this game. And there's no way you're going to throw out Brittany Gomez at the plate. She was hauling. And Harluck moves on to third. This has been some kind of hitting streak that Hartman's on. She is just really swinging the bat well, using all fields.
That'll bring up Allie Kappert for the Cyclones. As Hartman almost gets in a rundown. Cyclone runners kind of doing a little dancing.
Well, they're so cognizant of Harluck at third that they didn't get Hartman. She was able to scamper back to the bag.
This would be another big run for the Cyclones. Sally Capper takes the 0-1 pitch. Down low for a ball.
Yes, Cyclones now with a 6-3 advantage, but wanting to add more. And a great chance to do it with Allie Kappert at the plate.
As Allie Kappert waits for the pitch, swung on down the left side, but foul.
A little collision there between Harluck and the third baseman, Zeller. Nothing to write home about.
Harluck at third, Hartman at first for the Cyclones. Two outs here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Cyclones scored one run on Hartman's hit.
Her 26th RBI of the season, so she's moving up there among the team leaders in RBIs as well, and she's moved into the cleanup spot and has really flourished there. Three RBIs yesterday for Hartman.
Kappert takes the 1-2 pitch, swung on down the left side, but foul.
Wind really blew that ball away from the left fielder, Brianna Luna, is really pushing that ball away.
Saw Luna try to drift over there, and that ball just took off.
Now the umpires are asking for some fresh softballs.
You wonder kind of when darkness comes into play. Obviously on the TV, it doesn't look as dark as it actually is out, but you wonder when that comes into play.
It's because our cameras are so good that they're showing it, allowing in more brightness into the camera. But yeah, you're right, it is darker when you're here in person, and it's going to be a factor, Mitch. No question. If this game goes seven, which every indication is that it will.
The 1-2 pitch swung on by Cappert. Over to his short. Blank puts it away for the Hawkeyes. But the Cyclones score one, make it a 6-3 ball game. Hawkeyes will come up in the top half of the fifth. You're watching Cyclones.tv.
Say bye to the dish.
Why?
You're getting Mediacom.
Why?
Because it's boundary free.
Why?
Because you can watch TV any way you want. Because DVR is included. Because you can watch TV everywhere. Because it's reliable in all weather. Because there are thousands of free shows on demand. Because we don't require a contract.
Why?
Why should we? It's easy to see why better TV is boundary free TV from Mediacom.
MidAmerican Energy is putting the power to achieve greater energy efficiency in our hands with free home energy audits, rebates on energy efficient products and appliances for our homes. Businesses win too through financial incentives and rebates on energy efficient equipment. Green saving power is in our hands with MidAmerican Energy.
Welcome back to the Cyclone Sports Complex. It is a 6-3 ball game now. Iowa State ahead of the Hawkeyes. Not two outs. We're in the top half of the fifth. We're done with the bottom of the fourth. Katie Johnson, you see her numbers on the day so far. 3 innings pitched, 3 hits given up, 2 errors and 2 walks and 4 strikeouts. So up for the Hawkeyes is the bottom of the order in Caitlin Malarkey. Malarkey struck out in her first at-bat.
Malarkey's a freshman from Park Ridge, Illinois. That's where Tom Crochelle's from, isn't it?
Look at that.
Yeah. Two famous people in Iowa from Park Ridge, Illinois.
Second pitch of the at-bat is fouled to the right side, 0-2.
I'm sure he'll be texting me to correct me within seconds here of what his actual hometown is. I think that's right.
6-3 ball game as Malarkey waits for the pitch from Johnson, delivered low for a ball. It continues to get dark out. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Malarkey swings it back to Johnson. Johnson flips it over Spendlove for the first out of the inning.
Well, one thing that Katie Johnson's done a really nice job of is going after the leadoff hitters in this game. She did allow the leadoff home run by Repley in the last inning, but she's not fooling around out there. She's going right after hitters. She's trying to mow them down, and she's only walked one on the day.
So Brianna Luna comes to the plate for the Hawkeyes.
Stand corrected. Blank has actually walked twice, but pretty good control so far for Johnson.
And the 1-0 pitch from Johnson swung on but fouled back.
Definitely getting darker here.
Yeah, it is. And here's the 1-1 pitch to Luna. Up high for a ball, 2-1. Luna has struck out and flown out to center in her 2 at-bats as Johnson sets and delivers. Swung on, that one's going to be in the gap in left center field and gone. Brianna Luna delivers for the Hawkeyes and makes this one a 6-4 game.
Well, we said Iowa doesn't really have a lot of power in its lineup, but that certainly hasn't been the case today, as that's just the second home run of the season for Luna, but the third home run of the day for Iowa, and a pitch from Johnson, belt high, and Luna just drove it right out of here.
So the Hawkeyes are 8-4 in the season when they hit home a home run.
Well, they've got 3 of them today.
We'll see what they can
might
do.
Might be a season high. They're up 6-4, or they're down 6-4, I should say.
So Johnson delivers the first pitch to Fritch outside for a ball.
And all this done with the wind blowing in, Mitch. The 3 home runs for Iowa. The flag's really blowing straight in from mm-hmm. left center.
The 1-0 pitch to Fritch is fouled back to the left side. Fritch struck out in her first at-bat and grounded out to second in her second at-bat. As the 1-1 pitch from Johnson is delivered, Fritch puts one into the right field for a base hit for the Hawkeyes.
Starting to swing the bats a little bit better here. And threatening to add some more runs here in the top half of the fifth.
Yeah, she takes that inside pitch nicely, puts it right in the right field. Right in front of Alec Capper. So that'll bring up Megan Blank for the Hawkeyes. Fritch the runner at first as Katie Johnson sets and delivers outside for a ball.
Mentioned it earlier in our broadcast, but Fritch the most likely base runner for Iowa. She's attempted 11 steals on the season, team high. She also has a team high 6 successful steals.
So the pitch is delivered for a strike. 1-1.
Blank has walked twice. And she is very selective up there, it appears.
She is. Katie Johnson sets and delivers, fouled off by Blank to the left side.
So after walking her the first two trips, Johnson getting ahead in the count here, 1-2. That should help.
Here's the 1-2 pitch to Blank. Swung on, fouled down the left side.
Running out of room was Harluck, as again that wind kind of pushing it away from the left fielder.
Fritch the base runner at first for the Hawkeyes. Has 6 stolen bases on the year. Megan Blank the hitter. As she waits for the 1-2 pitch from Johnson. Swung on, fouled back.
Good battle right here.
It is. Blank's had a few good battles this game. Rapley's had a few good battles. So these Hawkeye hitters know how to fight it off.
It's starting to rain again a little bit.
So the 1-2 pitch is delivered low for a ball. 2-2.
We managed to get about, I'd say, 45 minutes to an hour without any rain.
Yep.
But now it's starting to come down a little bit once again. Hopefully this isn't that arrival of that second cell that we saw on the radar. Skies don't look too threatening right now.
2-2 with one out here in the top of the fifth. And the pitch is delivered outside for a ball. 3-2. Blank, like we mentioned, has 2 walks on the day.
We'll see if they send Fritch with one away here to try to stay out of the double play.
And here's the 3-2 pitch from Johnson. Swung on, and that one is deep to center field. And gone. Megan Blank delivers a home run for the Hawkeyes. It is a 2-run home run that will tie this game at 6.
4th home run of the day for Iowa. A 2-run shot by Megan Blank. That's her 2nd home run of the season. So it's not like these are hitters who are normally producing a ton of power. But 4 different Hawkeye hitters have left the yard today. And all of a sudden, Mitch, we've got a 6-6 game. None of the Cyclone runs coming via the long ball. And Katie Johnson trying to get herself collected here and come right back at the heart of this lineup.
Holly Hoffman will be the hitter for the Hawkeyes. She waits for the pitch, and that one is delivered low for a ball. Iowa State continues to get up in this game, and then the Hawkeyes continue to fight back.
Johnson has allowed 31 home runs on the season. So she does tend to, you know, come at hitters,
yep,
and challenge them. And a few of them have made her pay. But there have been many good pitchers through the years that have allowed some home runs. But if they have a short memory, it doesn't cause as much damage as it could. Now,
yep,
she's allowed 4 of them here today. So you wonder about her psyche a little bit here with a 2-0 count.
As Hartman goes out to talk to Johnson. And the 2-0 pitch from Johnson is swung on down the left side, but foul.
Yeah, just barely foul past third base.
Hoffman flew out to first and center in her 2 at-bats today. Two-one with one out here in the top of the fifth. And Katie Johnson delivers inside for a strike.
Good pitch. Inner half, 2-2 now.
I'm getting a lot of interference.
Here's Johnson's 2-2 pitch inside for a ball. 3-2.
Hoffman 0-2 on the day, the cleanup hitter for Iowa. And she's gone quietly, but the rest of the lineup hasn't with those four home runs.
So here's the payoff pitch inside for a ball. So Hoffman walks, puts herself on for the Hawkeyes with one out here in the top half of the fifth.
Now you get inning that started auspiciously for Katie Johnson. She got the leadoff hitter, but then the home run by Luna. She allowed a base hit and then another home run. Megan Blank with a two-run blast and now the walk. So it's been a struggle for Katie Johnson here in the top half of the fifth.
Doesn't get any easier now. Now you got Repley coming into plate. Looks like we're going to have a pitching change for the Cyclones. You're watching Cyclones.tv.
Shouldn't your network work even when you don't want to? Whether you're out of pocket up here, decompressing way out here, or defrosting just the other side of nowhere, shouldn't the choice to be out of touch be up to you and not your spotty wireless provider? At U.S. Cellular, we started our network where the others left off, bringing 4G LTE to nearly 90% of our customers. We've got local and national coverage covered. U.S. Cellular, hello better.
Back here at the Cyclone Sports Complex, we have a pitching change for the Cyclones. Paris Immels will come in and pitch for the Cyclones, as is a 6-6 ball game with Holly Hoffman at first base and Whitney Repley to the plate.
Repley. Go ahead, Mitch.
Repley has a home run in this game so far.
One of four Hawks to leave the yard.
And Immels delivers the first pitch changeup for a strike.
Iowa on the season coming into this game, Mitch, in 38 games, had hit 13 home runs as a team. They have hit four home runs today.
Impressive day for the Hawkeyes, to say the least. And here's the 0-1 pitch from Immels. Swung on over to the right side. Davis picks it up, fires over to Spendlove at first for the second out of the inning.
Good job by Davison to make sure to get the sure out. That ball was spinning like a cue shot. And now the dangerous hitter, Massey, up there trying to break this tie as darkness continues to set in here. And see Davison could have maybe flipped it to second, but just made sure to get an out. That's the smart play.
So Kayla Massey will come to the plate. She takes the first pitch outside for a ball.
Massey hit the home run to get it going for Iowa. The two-run shot into the wind in left center. Big strong hitter. She's the starting pitcher for the Hawks as well.
Second pitch is delivered outside for a ball, 2-0.
And the rain's starting to pick up now, Mitch, too.
Not only the rain now, but the darkness also a factor.
Yeah, no question.
And here's the 2-0 pitch from Immels. Swung onto the right side. That one's going to get through. Allie Kappert picks it up, fires it over to home. In time for the out. Allie Kappert throws out the Hawkeye runner to create the third out of the inning. Nice throw by Allie Kappert.
You know, she did it from left field yesterday, threw out a runner at the plate, and today from right field, Allie Kappert guns down another runner at the plate. What a great throw by the Ankeny native, and a big out in this ball game.
So Hoffman is retired, and that'll bring up Spendlove, Davis, and Rice for the Cyclones in the bottom of the fifth. You're watching Cyclones.tv.
Hey! Check it out.
DSL. It's so cheap.
Like it? Now people will switch back.
Well, MediaCom is still up to 10 times faster.
Yeah.
And pretty much necessary for homes with lots of devices.
Well, yeah.
And the recent FCC report said that Mediacom delivered on its 15 meg speeds, and DSL didn't. So, really?
DSL is overpriced.
Yeah. The fact is, with faster proven speeds, more people switch to Mediacom for the real deal.
We'll never know if somehow, in some way, we can affect the outcome of a game. But when the clock's winding down and everything's on the line, we all believe.
Back here at the Cyclone Sports Complex, as we see the third out of the top half of the fifth inning, Alec Kappert throws it in time at home.
Yeah, good job by Hartman. Close play at the plate as the runner tried to slide in under the tag, but Alec Kappert, second straight day throwing out a runner at the plate from the outfield. And for somebody who doesn't play the outfield that often, pretty impressive. 6-6 game, and the Cyclones try to get the bats going here in the bottom half of the fifth.
Spenlove, Davison, and Rice are the hitters for the Cyclones. 6-6 ball game. Jordan Spenlove is 1-for-1 with a single, RBI, and a walk so far today. As the first pitch is delivered outside for a ball. I mean, from the booth, we're almost at the point of darkness now where mm-hmm. the scoreboard is lighting the field a little bit.
So you're not reaching too much there. Again, our cameras, we can turn the gain up, it's called, on our cameras, which we've done a little bit here to improve the amount of brightness allowed into the camera, but it is darker here in person than it looks on camera.
Spenlove swings at the 2-0 pitch for a strike. 2-1 to Spenlove. Has a base hit and a walk so far today. 2-1 swung on over to right field, and Navarro puts it away for the Hawkeyes.
Spenlove with good contact, but hit right at the right fielder, and Navarro was playing her perfectly, so one up, one down.
It's one of those swings as a hitter, you know you put a good swing on it, but right at someone. Doesn't get worse than that as a hitter.
Especially when you're in a slump.
Yeah. Sarah Davison will come to the plate for the Cyclones, takes the first pitch low for a ball.
Which we might add, Jordan Spenlove has not been in a slump. She's been swinging the bat really well.
Davison is 1-for-2 with a triple and 2 RBIs on the day. Delivered a huge triple back in the bottom of the third.
And the catcher pointing out something about the batter's box, which has pretty much disappeared by now. So Davison will stand in there pretty much any way she likes.
So Davison takes the 1-0 pitch up high for a ball. Six-six ball game here in the bottom of the fifth. As the pitch is delivered outside for a ball. 3-0 to Davison.
And as it does get darker, the fact they play with a neon yellow ball helps.
Davison draws a walk for the Cyclones as she trots down to first. It's almost like playing night golf. Got that orange-yellow ball.
Well, Sarah Rice has struck out twice, but she's going to stand in here with a big opportunity here to try to get this run home. We'll see a visit to the mound for Iowa. Didn't see anybody warming up, so I don't think they're going to make a change. Their pitcher, Kayla Massey, trying to remove some mud from her cleats. You can see there's plenty of it.
Hawkeye players around her kind of laughing. Not a whole lot you can do as a pitcher when it's muddy like that.
Nope, just try to battle through it. So it's a quick visit to the mound. And Rice will stand in there with a runner aboard and one out.
Sarah Rice so far today is 0-for-2.
Struck out both times.
And Rice takes the first pitch for a strike. Throw back over to first, not in time.
Another big cut from Sarah Rice. She doesn't get cheated up there, but she's having trouble locating the ball so far in this one. Massey, not a big strikeout pitcher, but she's gotten Rice twice so far in this game.
And here's the 0-1 pitch. bunted down the first baseline as Rice trips and is tagged out for the first out. However, Davison moves over to second.
Well, it got the job done, and now it's up to Matty Reese to try to get that runner home.
So you wonder if Stacy Gemeinhardt-Sessler trying to maybe catch the Hawkeyes off guard there with that call. As Matty Reese steps in and takes the first pitch low for a ball.
Reese has singled in this game, 1-for-2, swinging the bat pretty well.
And here's the 0-1 pitch, swung on to center field, and Erickson moves over for the third out of the inning. So Cyclones don't put any runs on the board here in the bottom of the fifth. Hawkeyes will come and hit in the top of the sixth in a tie game. You're watching Cyclones.tv.
Hey, check it out.
DSL. It's so cheap.
Like it? Now people will switch back.
Well, MediaCom is still up to 10 times faster.
Yeah.
And pretty much necessary for homes with lots of devices.
Well, yeah.
And the recent FCC report said that MediaCom delivered on its 15 meg speeds, and DSL didn't. So, really?
DSL is overpriced.
Yeah. The fact is, with faster proven speeds, more people switch to MediaCom for the real deal.
Well, folks, we're done. As they have called the ball game because of darkness, it is a 6-6 tie between Iowa State and Iowa in the Iowa Corn Cy-Hawk Series. So a 6-6 final through five innings. Mitch Gerber, I don't recall seeing anything quite like that before. And we did mention it several times that it was getting pretty dark here. So when Stacy Gemeinhardt-Sessler in the top half or the bottom half of that fifth bunted, moved the runner over second, just trying to get that lead run home any way possible to get the lead before they called it off, but couldn't do it. And so so this is an unusual way to end a softball battle.
Big rain delay. And then you talked about Stacy Gemeinhardt-Sessler trying to do something because she probably knows the darkness is coming into a factor and couldn't generate that last run, so this one ends in a weird tie.
Cyclones get six runs without the benefit of a home run. Iowa hit four home runs, and accounting for a good chunk of their six runs. And Iowa and Iowa State play to a 6-6 tie here at Cyclone Sports Complex. And we will visit with Stacy Gemeinhardt-Sessler in just a moment, so stay with us on Cyclones.tv. 6-6 was our final score here at Cyclone Sports Complex in a game shortened to five innings thanks to an hour and a half rain delay. And we visit now with Stacy Gemeinhardt-Sessler. And Stacy, unfortunate that weather played such a big factor today.
Yeah, I mean, it definitely is. We definitely need some more light to keep on going. But, you know, it is what it is, and I guess it just wasn't meant to be to play seven.
You bunted with Rice and tried to get Reese an opportunity with a runner in scoring position. Were you thinking about the darkness when that play occurred?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, yeah, we were thinking about the darkness even in the top of the fifth. You know, we were trying to get to work fast, and we just couldn't work fast enough, you know, without giving up some runs. And then definitely just trying to get a run across as fast as we could.
You swung the bats well early in this ball game, got a good lead, but unfortunately Iowa, which hasn't shown a ton of power throughout the season, hit four home runs on the day.
Yeah, they did, and you know, we had an error on that front one, and so that adds, you know, another run. But, you know, I mean, they did, and we just, you know, we got to keep the ball in the park. But I think, you know, a good job on our offense, because we had talked about yesterday after the game when, you know, we had so many hits, but then we really didn't score a lot of runs. And here, when we talked about closing that gap between how many hits you have and how many runs you score, and I thought we did a great job doing that.
Well, it's on to Texas Tech for a weekend series, and then you're back home, and four more home games, four more chances for fans to get out and see the Cyclones. This team's hitting the ball among the top teams in the country. They're fun to watch.
Yeah, we definitely do some good things offensively. I think last time that we were ranked like 17th in the country in hitting, and so it's exciting. I think we have a lot of speed, some power, and we run an exciting game.
All right, a 6-6 tie here today between Iowa State and Iowa in the Iowa Corn Cy-Hawk Series. Stacy Gemeinhardt-Sessler, our guest. Thanks for watching this broadcast on Cyclones.tv.